Hi, and welcome to a Makers Making Change tutorial. In this video, we'll show you how to build a device from our open source library called the Simple Switch Tester. If you want to find the build files, build materials, or other information, please find the project page for this device in the website or in the video description. First, we must prepare a workspace and get our supplies together. For the switch tester parts, you'll need the 3D printed cover plate, enclosure top, enclosure bottom, tactile switch, 3.5mm jack, LED light, 68-ohm quarter watt resistor, battery holder, and two AAA batteries. Now for the tools we will need: pliers, wire strippers, flush cutters, tweezers, super glue, and a soldering iron with solder.
If you're following along in the build, plug in your soldering iron to allow it to heat up. Make sure the tip of the iron is clear from everything. Finally, make sure to wear your safety glasses and wash your hands after soldering.
Note that the number on the top left of the screen corresponds to the steps on the written instructions. To begin, you'll need the cover plate and enclosure top. Apply a thin layer of glue on the inner edges of the enclosure top. Place the cover plate on the glued surface before it dries. Make sure the engraved text is facing up and the triangular shaped end of the cover plate matches the indent in the enclosure top. Press firmly and set aside. Now take the battery holder and a measuring device. Approximately measure 9 centimeters from the end of the red wire and make a cut. Then measure 7 centimeters from the end of the black wire and make a cut. Strip the ends of both the cut wires and the wires attached to the battery holder. Strip about 1 centimeter off of each end. Now twist each of the wires individually until tight. Now prepping the wires is complete and your wires should look like this. Take the stripped ends of the wires and use the pliers to bend a hook on each of the ends. Do this for all exposed wire. The hook should look like this when you're complete. Take the LED and notice that one of the leads is shorter than the other. On that same side, the plastic is flat. This is the negative lead of the LED. Just as we did with the wires, bend the ends of both leads of the LED. Now find the negative side and hook it to the black wire attached to the battery holder. Now solder this in place. Take the resistor and bend both ends into a hook. Attach it to the positive lead of the LED and solder it in place. Now take the non-soldered end of the resistor and bend a loop in it right before the hook. This can be tricky, so make sure to use pliers. This is what the final bend should look like, with the loop right before the hook. Attach the loose black wire to the loop and solder it in place. Take the tactile switch and cut off one side of the leads and the two black nubs on the back using the flush cutters. Then using pliers, bend the two remaining leads into an L shape. The tactile switch lead should not be touching the black wire that was just soldered in,
and should only be in contact with the resistor. Use the hook part of the resistor to attach the bottom lead of the tactile switch and solder it in place. Take the anchored red wire coming from the battery holder and attach it to the top switch lead of the tactile switch. Then take the loose red wire and also attach one end to the top switch lead. Then when both wires are attached to the lead, solder them in place. Take the 3.5 millimeter jack and bend the lead farthest from the port at 90 degrees, then bend the other two leads at a 45 degree angle. Take the loose red wire and attach to the lead closest to the port, and attach the loose black wire to the middle lead. Solder these in place. Insert the two AAA batteries. Press the tactile switch. If the red LED lights up when pressed, the device is working. Now take the bottom enclosure and place the battery holder into the slot. Ensure the wires are facing the right side. Take the LED and fit it into the round hole on the left side of the enclosure. Press down gently until it is secure. There's a slot for the tactile switch to fit into. Make sure that the wires that are soldered to the switch are on the left side of the slot so they can exit. Press the switch into the slot. Unscrew the nut on the jack and place the jack inside the cutout on the right side of the enclosure. Ensure all the wires are inside and place the top enclosure onto the bottom enclosure. It should snap into place. Make sure the hole on the top enclosure lines up with the LED. Screw the nut back onto the jack end. The switch tester build is now complete. Test out by pressing the tactile switch on the side or plugging in an external switch to light up the LED. This device can now be used to test if an adaptive switch is working.
Thank you so much for watching our video and making the world a better place by volunteering for Makers Making Change.